Hi, this show, our focus is on natural health, and there are three specific topics that are going to be touched on by our star naturopath, who is also a reflexologist and an iridologist. If you don't know what that is, it's time that you do need to know. Sally Nutini is joining us here today. She's a registered nurse and a healing touch therapist as well. But our focus is on Dr. Tony Koufos, and he started out many years ago with reflexology and iridology, and then went to school to become a naturopath as well, which he's practiced for several years now. So he's going to be giving us a lecture on these topics, and it's very, very interesting for everybody from children all the way up to the aged and the elderly. So I'd like to introduce you first to Sally Nutini, who's going to be helping and assisting him, and Dr. Tony Koufos. And the focus is on you, Dr. Koufos. Teach us.
Okay, I'll try to introduce you to what these skills are that is studied under the heading of naturopathy. And I've taught it at the College of DuPage, and so it's been out there for quite a few years. But in the naturopathic study, we basically learn methods of natural healing, natural approaches to solving health issues. And by doing that, throughout history, herbs, diet, fundamentally has been around for a few thousand years. And that's fundamentally what I kind of follow. And in the naturopathic study, a lot of the naturopaths may specialize because it's such a broad area. I mean, this has been going on for thousands of years, and the medical industry's only been around for about 150 years or so. And so this has been around much longer than that, been time proven in its uses, and it's biblical also. But in naturopathy, my specialty, and the ones that I kind of zeroed in and liked very much, was the form of reflexology, iridology, and herbs. And with those approaches to health, we can pretty much find out what people's issues are and then how to solve them. In reflexology, for example, the chart that's right in front of you, and I'll try and move around here to show you what this is about. Reflexology is the study of the science of acupressure points on the bottom of the feet, the hands, and the ears. And in reflexology, all your organs and systems are shown through the bottom of the feet, and the reflexes are on the bottom of the feet. For example, in the center, upper center of the foot, the medial part of the foot, is a lung area. The edge of the foot relates to the spine, all the way from the sacrum to the coccyx to seven cervicals at the top of the neck, all the way down to the sacrum. So you've got your colon, you've got your kidneys, you've got your ureter tube, your bladder, stomach, adrenal glands. All the organs basically are reflected on the bottom of the feet. So when I read the eyes in iridology, and I would like to show you a chart that relates to iridology. Iridology has been around for a few thousand years, especially originally we might argue the point of in Tibet. So in the iris of the eye, we also have all the organs in the body reflected in the iris of the eye. And the Russians have PhDs in iridology, so it's a solid science throughout the world. And Russians and German naturopaths, Australia, New Zealand, European countries, Italy, Greece, iridology is common there and known very well. So in the iris of the eye, I use an 8-power lens, a loop, and a light, and I just look into your eye. And I can look and see just about how all these organs are doing. In other words, if you go to a medical doctor and have a lab test, the lab test will probably show on a scale of 1 to 10, 9 on that scale. From 8 3/4 down to 1 or 2, there's no way of finding out the state or health of that particular organ or degree of inflammation. So in the iris of the eye, we can tell from discolorations, from the trabeculi, as far as how the tension is in the iris, also the state of health in the body. We can actually observe the level of stress in the iris of the eye. And the more intense the stress, the more tighter the lines are that relate to stress in the iris of the eye. So in the center part is the intestines, and we can actually see areas of the thyroid, the kidneys, the lungs, the liver, reproductive organs, spinal column. Everything is written in the iris of the eye. And there are even zones in the brain that reflect the different parts and different emotions that relate to the thought patterns. So there's a lot to be said about the study of the iris of the eye. When I was studying under one particular naturopath many years ago, in his later years, it took him over 2 hours to do a complete reading of the iris of the eye, so he got very advanced. And as I mentioned again, Russians have PhDs in this study. But in the iris of the eye, I would look for an example. If somebody came to me with health issues, and I would say, I want to observe into your iris of your eye and see what's going on there. And because it's difficult for some people to accept the fact that that can be observed in the eye, I learned reflexology. And reflexology, I can relate to the client. So if I look in the eye and I see an area of the colon that has a discomfort or stress, then I will hit the reflex on the foot that relates to the colon. And that area would be right about there. So if I push there with my hand, just pressure, and the person says, oh, that's tender there, they will have felt what I've observed in the iris of the eye. So with that understanding, I would recommend a diet adjustment if necessary and herbs that would support that area. And usually in serious issues, we can see changes in the person's health by this approach in 30, 60 to 90 days. And we've had people that come to me, even though we don't diagnose diseases, we can work with people that have been diagnosed with specific diseases and work with those problems and see them start to improve. So with iridology and reflexology, diet recommendations, and certain herbs that support those organs, we can see major improvements in the person's health. Now, generally speaking, yes.
So, Tony, if I'm correct, then it seems like if someone comes to your office, you can actually start the treatment within that session. You're not waiting for a lot of lab results. Are you implying that?
That's correct.
That you can look at the eye,
yes,
and you could do reflect. So a person coming to you can immediately
start working on improving their health.
And you can do that in that first session. You're not waiting for results to come back a couple of days or a week. I mean, that's pretty dramatic that someone coming to you that can find some either hope or relief or some paths to begin to improve their life patterns.
Yes. And that first session takes about an hour. So I will probably find in the average person 5 to 15 things that they can work on for the next few years, really. Because as we start to improve our health, generally speaking, naturopathically speaking, for every 5 years of abuse, 1 year of recovery. So if something's been going on with a person's health for 15 or 20 years, give themselves a year or 2 years to turn it around, but within 30, 60 to 90 days, they'll find that they're starting to improve, which gives them the enthusiasm to keep on going. And that's how the body responds. We're not working with symptoms, we're working on improving the condition. And that's a little different, and that's an approach that seems to be getting more popular, and people are becoming more aware that they don't want to deal with symptoms anymore. They want to improve their health so that they can be well in their later years as well as their early years.
Well, Tony, one thing I wanted to bring up is cost is often an issue.
Yes.
And although insurances may or may not cover alternative care like this, it's probably less costly than the copays of other medical procedures.
Yes.
So it would not be, you know, too much for someone to pay for it on their own.
That's right. Initially, the service fee is $195, takes an hour, and any follow-up appointment is usually $75 or $95, depending on the time that we take. But with these approaches, they're so simple, non-invasive, fun after you get used to the idea of what we're doing. And I usually have some therapies that might help with stress. And stress, they're claiming today that 75% of all health issues are stress-related. So I can see the tension in the iris of the eye. So these conditions can improve. So with that approach, just to give you an idea, reflexology is actually engraved.
Tilt it this way.
This way?
Mm-hmm. A little, no. Just
down,
so everyone can see it.
Yeah. The reflection. In the crypts, in the physician's tomb in Egypt, 2300 BC. That's quite a ways back. So this has been around for a long time. It's nothing new, very popular throughout the world. Also,
and it's accessible. I mean, you could quickly go to someone's foot. It's not difficult.
Yes.
So just take off your shoe and your stocking, and then you can start some procedure or some assessment.
Absolutely. And a lot of times I work with people so that they can learn a little bit about what they're doing, and then they can do some homework along the way.
So you give them some instruction to take home, and they could do it on themselves. Or if someone comes with them, you can teach their spouse or a family member to help them as well.
Absolutely.
They're easily to learn once you point out the landmarks and the positions.
Yes, and they'll get a better understanding of health and how to take care of themselves. That's what gets exciting. Because once this approach starts in the family, if one of the members of the family comes for this issue, usually it just goes right through the family, and they all start getting interested and curious about what they can do to help out, which is exciting.
My sister gave me a book in reflexology, and I've been practicing it on my husband, and he just loves it. He says, you know, like, do it again, do more. It's it's very soothing and comforting. And
common remark is, I'll give you an hour to quit. But that is one of the great approaches. With reflexology, with iridology, was so powerful that we can see so many wonderful things in the iris of the eye. Then there are other methods, just to introduce you to other things that we can learn from that. There are also a method of tongue analysis, which is more or less of a Chinese origin that's been around for quite some time. And we can learn different things that happen. Just for an example, the tip of the tongue relates to heart issues. And discolorations on the tongue usually reflects the catarrh or different toxins that might be in the intestinal tract. These are areas that can be addressed.
Yeah, if you want to hold that up for a few more minutes so people can see, if you stick your tongue out and see any of those things. I remember somebody having to go to the doctor about little white spots on their tongue. And it turned out that it was an irritation from toothpaste. But it was a scary thing because they thought they might have cancer or something.
Sure.
You know. So there are different things you can look at in the tongue. And you can find out anemia. You can find out all different kinds of things from looking at the tongue.
Yeah.
What are a couple of those things relate to that we're looking at now?
Well, this particular one relates to lung and respiratory issues like a white coating on the tongue. This one here relates to sinus issues. Getting back into this area, this relates to kidney issues, and you can see that there's some things going on there. It gets pretty graphic and clear, and you don't need a lot of big testing equipment to figure out that there's issues in that area that you can work on. And as your health improves, you can see these changes. So you can kind of self-help yourself.
We're all used to going to the doctor and sticking our tongue out and having a tongue blade to look in the back at the uvula and the tonsils and things like that.
Yes. And for an example, this colorful chart here isn't quite what you might think it is. These are parasites. These are conditions that people can have that they can get into their systems from either cooked food or from their pets. You know, this is not unusual. It is said that 75% of Americans have some form of bacterial type parasites within their body, and it'd be nice to get rid of the ones that are giving them trouble. Mm-hmm. There's been situations where I've had, can I give an example of this one lady that I put on a detox program, a cleansing program, and after 3 months, she passed a 12-foot tapeworm. So that was kind of interesting.
Was it making her thin, though? Was the tapeworm eating?
Well, it obviously was, because she was not overweight.
Okay.
So do we want to ingest? I don't know.
I think
that's pretty dramatic for weight loss.
Well, with people traveling, is this more of a problem today with the parasites?
Absolutely.
People
travel and they come back
and they have...
Yes. I had an example a few years ago where a gentleman came in and he'd been coming in for regular reflexology treatments, which is good maintenance if somebody starts to learn and find that it helps them out and helps de-stress them, because reflexology is also good for stress management. But he went, I was hitting all the reflexes on his foot, and all of a sudden the area on his foot of the kidney was very tender. And I says, Herman, that reflex is normally never tender. What did you do in the last couple weeks? Well, he said, I guess I just came back from China. Mm. So he must have eaten something there. And
another thing people don't think about is, you know, washing your sheets frequently and everything is a good idea, because there are some parasites that eat off of our skin.
Sure.
And washing pillows instead of just pillowcases is a good idea, too.
Sure, absolutely.
Because you keep putting that pillowcase back on there and there's things that end up in there.
Yeah, and most people... medically speaking, they don't address, you know, this approach, and it could create some major issues in some people. What's also interesting is in the iris of the eye, we can see what's going on in the colon. And because it's so important, they used to say that death begins in the colon. So depending on constipation, and people should move their bowels every day. We can always talk about that because it's very important, because there are nerve reflexes that reflex out from different areas of the colon to different parts of the body.
You know, I was just amazed at, I just met with somebody who has a pacemaker in their hip to make their colon work properly, and leads that were put into her spine, because she had some problems with sphincter problems, I guess that came after the birth of a baby and something was irritating or cut the sphincter. And they are now doing this, and I don't know all about it because I just heard this from the patient, but she has a pacemaker in her hip to help her colon be controlled, and leads in her spine.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's an issue. Tough to be under that situation.
Mm-hmm.
If you do a lot of this preventive stuff, hopefully that'll never have to be done. But from the colon, for an example, I had a gentleman a few years back that was on some heart medication. And when I checked him, I felt that he did not have a heart issue. But he said, I need to take that because my doctor recommended it, and I can understand that. Well, after a few years, he'd call me, and after he just went to the hospital, and he had blood in his stool. And I said, well, when you come back, let me check at the office to look at this chart to just see what might be related to that area. He had an ulcer in his transverse colon and just down the descending colon. Well, actually, his heart fibrillations, from what we interpreted afterwards, was that the medication was creating the irritation, which it will do over a period of time, into the colon. And the reflex area where he had an ulcer in the colon was the reflex point that related to the heart. So actually, the medication over a period of years had created an irritation that was causing the heart fibrillation. So he really didn't have a heart problem, he had a colon problem. So that's what's exciting about this approach to looking at things. These are preventive approaches, very supportive of what's going on in the
body.
Well,
I think what's interesting is something you haven't addressed yet behind you is the diagnostic face reading chart.
I think that's
very interesting, because we have about 8 minutes left, so I want to make sure that we touch on that completely.
Wow. This chart is so interesting, because the eye chart is a constant reading of what your health is now. Because it reflects, as it says, the human face is not set in stone. It's constantly changing based on the health of the internal organs. So when we look at the face, we can look at different areas. For example, the tip of the nose. If you see somebody with a wart or some growth or redness or some irritation on the tip of the nose, that's related to heart issues. Okay? Now when we're talking about underneath the eyes, the kidneys, the half moon under the eye relates to kidney area. So any of this dark stuff under the eye can relate to kidneys. And I can validate that, double check, by hitting the reflex point on your foot that relates to kidney. And if I push on that spot and you say that's tender, that was a double check. One that you can see and one that you can feel. So that's a double relationship to that organ. Now that doesn't mean that it's terrible, that doesn't mean that it's number 9 on a scale of 1 to 10. It could be an 8. But people start having issues long before a lab test will reveal that particular problem, because many times I've had people come to me with thyroid issues and they've just come back from the doctor and the doctor says your thyroid is fine, and when I check on the foot, the thyroid is under an inflammatory state, so it's not happy and it's not working well. So we start working on improving that organ nutritionally, emotionally, or with nutrition, with herbs and diet to start improving that area. Because in the Midwest, our area here is devoid of iodine in the soil, so that relates to thyroid issues. Also, with the lungs, this particular pocket in the cheek, right underneath the cheekbone, if it really recesses in, you can look at people in your family, and if it really goes in, it kind of shows that there is a lung issue and maybe a breathing issue, maybe a little bit of asthma as a child. The little lungs that when you start realizing that you've had some health lung issues in previous years, it reflects there and the issues are still going on. People that have smoked for 15 or 20 years and quit smoking, they think everything is fine. They still have lungs that need to be cleaned up. And once you start getting cleaned up and having them working better, then you're getting yourself out of trouble. Also, in the area of the cheek, the lines ascending here, coming down and descending here relate to the intestines. And if there's the really heavy, deep grooves, or if there's little pimples or any type of eruption in that particular area, there's things going on in the ascending, transverse, descending, colon, and also the intestines, all areas right in here. Now we get up into the forehead. This can relate to one of two things, either stress, these vertical lines here, or liver, either one. I can check the reflex on the foot to validate if it's liver. And of course the stress, I would see the trabeculi and see the tension in the iris of the eye related to stress. So there's couple, three ways of checking those areas. Right across here relates to intestines also.
I'm checking Sally's face as you're saying this. I haven't found anything wrong yet.
Oh. Well, I was just thinking good. How comprehensive this is. You can go from one system, the eyes, to the feet, mm-hmm. and the face, and then it validates or yes. reinforces what you're finding. And this is so simple and non-invasive.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. It is so
and the
different.
Cure or the treatment is supplements usually, supplement. And these treatments,
yes.
which are massage.
Usually.
Mm-hmm. It can be the foot bath.
Could be the detox foot bath. Could be some type of back manipulation that works to the spine, because the spine reflects to the nerves, to all the organs that we may be dealing with. The mm-hmm. foot reflexology, the acupressure on the points, and also the swing machine that I have at the office where you lie down and some of the people just take a nap on it because it's so wonderful. But they put their feet on top of this machine that rocks the ankles back and forth and also helps move the lymphatic system. And on that particular machine, they say that 30% of the value of that treatment is after it shuts off, because you will feel an energy flow up and down the body, which is the movement of the lymphatics.
And the lymphatics are?
And their locations?
The drainage?
Of the system. Mm-hmm. I kind of relate it to people in a way that the colon, if we can think about Katrina and the overflow and the toxins in the city of New Orleans and the overflow would be the colon, and then the overflowing of the banks would be the lymphatic system. So we need to keep the lymph clean, and we need to keep the colon clean. And that's very important. Remember, if we eat 3 major meals a day, we need to eliminate three eliminations a day. And how many people do that? Not a lot.
And people should take probiotics too, particularly if you've ever been on antibiotics recently or something that killed the normal flora in your system. You need to supplement it with the good bacteria to get it back. I just had someone call me and say that he was nauseated and had a terrible problem. He went to the doctor, he got all these blood tests. It's a week later, he still wasn't feeling good, so he called me. And I said to take probiotics, to get some Gaviscon because he was nauseated and stuff like that. And he took a couple of the things that I suggested to him, and he called me up and said, I feel fine now.
Yes.
The doctor just called me and told me that there's nothing wrong, but I was feeling bad, and now I feel fine from just
sure.
those things, you know.
Well, that's right, and he's doing his job well, except that the methods that they're using.
I don't know if that was well. Why didn't the doctor tell him the things I told him to relieve the symptoms?
Well, you know, that's true, because then, yeah. you know, they've been taught a certain way, and that's, you know.
And another thing is, he had a bladder problem, and if you have urgency of the bladder or something, sitting in a tub will often help you. But there also used to be a drug named azogantrazine that was an antibiotic and a combination antispasmodic for bladder infections, and it was taken off the market for some strange reason. I don't know why, if they couldn't prove it was synergistic or what. Hmm. But azo is over the counter now, and that will stop some of the bladder spasming or something if you have a extreme urgency or irritation from an infection.
Sure.
It's not an antibiotic, though.
Well, what's interesting is, you know, under the emergency and acute situations like that, that's where the value. And I really highly respect these surgeons that do these tremendous jobs on people that have, you know, accidents and trauma.
Mm-hmm.
But in prevention and trying to maintain good health, it's good for the people to start learning about how they can take care of themselves. Mm-hmm. And this is basically what a naturopath does, is educate the people on what's mm-hmm. really going on in their body and what they can do themselves to improve it. And
now,
we just guide
them along.
They
can get information from you at 630-637-8403. I have that on speed dial in my brain because I call them for so many things. And if you need to get the number, you can call me, or you can, the credits are at the end of the show, or you can always email me at asktvnurse@yahoo.com. We're talking to Dr. Tony Koufos, K-O-U-F-O-S. You can go to his website at pathtonaturalhealth.com. And he's located in the Fairview Medical Building at 63rd and Fairview in Downers Grove. The number again is 630-637-8403 if you want a brochure or any information. And thank you for joining us. He's in town on Tuesday, Wednesdays, and Thursdays because we share him with Indiana on Mondays and Fridays. So thank you for joining us. Sally Nutini, thank you for assisting.